Hello there everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today is a little bit different of a video for you. This is the 8x8 house challenge, 64 squares or less. I had done a video like this way back and it was pretty square, and the video I ended up locking for a reason that I explained on a previous video. But one of my favorite YouTubers, Bedrock, and for that matter one of my favorite ladies, was asking about this because I mentioned it, and here's her channel, by the way. Check her out. She is wonderful. She had heard me mention about this challenge in the houseboat video, so I told her, you know what, you haven't seen it. I will rebuild it and tag you. So the items that it must include are your general phone, computer, couch, bed, toilet, sink, bookshelf, stereo, shower, stove, fridge, lighting, dining table, dining chairs, and television. Basically all the essentials of a sim life, and mainly just that you would be able to complete any kind of quest in it. So if you need to screenshot this list or just run it back, please do. But for anyone who wants to take this challenge, it is fun. Now the first one that I built was a square house, and it didn't take me too long to build it and fit everything in. It was a little bit of a challenge, but I enjoyed doing it more this time, so I'm glad that I agreed to redo it. And you can see there is a basement here, but I had just used it on an older home for the weather machine. So we're gonna take a quick tour of this one. This one is not square, but as you'll see at the end, it is 64 squares exactly. This is the living room, so I have put in a dresser since I could not fit one in the bedroom, and used that also as the TV stand and for a lamp there. I did manage to fit in a sectional, a rather large bookshelf, and the stereo into the living area there, and I think it turned out really cute. I love this little room. There's just something about these little houses and these little kitchens that I love doing. And here is the kitchen, and as you can see, it's anything you would need. There's a coffee maker there, a fridge, a stove, and a sink, and even a little wine rack, which I wish they could use, but we can't let them do that. So anyway, let's move on to the dining area here. I did have to put the computer in here, but there is a dining table here. Now, I know that they can't get to those inside chairs, but that's fine. There is a place for the Sims to eat, and that is definitely one of the requirements. And there's the computer over there in the corner, which is pretty much always now used to do quests with. So that's the little dining area, and then we're gonna go through this doorway here, and we have the bedroom. You could put a twin bed in yours. I chose to do a double bed in case I do wanna move a couple in here. So it's just a bed and two lamps, and that is also where I put the phone. And there's also an exit to this cute little patio out here where I haven't used this in a while, now that we can use those little benches, but I put one of those nice benches from the spa lot. And then through here we have the bathroom, which is pretty, you know, it's a pretty good size for a tiny house bathroom. And I'm so glad we can do this now. This made it a lot easier than when I did it last time, because they can still use the items, which by the way is another requirement. They have to be able to get to the items. So you can't tuck a bookshelf behind a couch. You know, they have to be able to actually use and get to all of the items. So let's look at the grid here real quick. It is 64 squares exactly. I did double check, but you can do it 64 or less, and you can see what I've done here. It really wasn't that hard. I mean, it's not easy to build a house if you know you have only so many squares to do it, but at the same time, it's kind of fun. And you know, you could actually use this layout and build onto it if you wanted to. I think it's really cute. If I did build onto it, I would definitely extend the dining room and the living room and possibly the bedroom, but I really like the layout. I just think it's nice. It's actually cute for one sim or even a couple. You could add a garage onto the side, but I'm just showing you where I put the furniture here. So if you're kind of feeling uninspired lately with building, because we all kind of go through that with the game, feel free to just try this. Now, I had seen on Facebook a while back a 6x6 challenge. I have not taken that one yet. I'd seen a few people who had, but when I looked at it, they didn't have like all the requirements that you would need for your sim to actually live there, which, you know, it's their town, it's their thing. But if you're gonna do it, I say go for it and try to get everything in there. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Check out Bedrock's channel. Love you guys, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.